Here's how to use Microsoft OneNote. Use the clickable sections below to skip through different parts of this tutorial. To create a new notebook, click on plus add notebook. A pop-up will appear. Click on plus new, then select your notebook color of choice. Then type in the name of your project. Let's say you're going on a trip. We'll call this trip. Then click create. In your notebook, you can create a section. This is a folder that will contain all your pages of notes. You'll see this colored file under your new notebook. Rename your first section by right-clicking on New Section 1 and click Rename. You can add as many sections as you want to your project. Just click Add Section at the bottom of the page and then type in what you'd like to call it. Under each section, you can add pages. This is where you'll make your notes and have all your notebook information. One will be created automatically under each section. You can rename this by typing above the date. To add another page, click on one of the sections and then Add Page button. If you have a large notebook, your sections may not be enough to organize your pages properly. You can break down your sections again by adding subsections. To do this, you'll need to add a new page and then convert it into a subsection. Right-click on that page and then New Page. Right-click on the page that you just created and select Make Subpage. This will turn it into a subsection. Now you have your working page and can start to make notes. Simply click on the page and start typing. You can move text around by clicking on the text and dragging it to the desired location on the page. You can also add visual links or other information to your page. From the top menu, click Insert and select whatever you'd like to add to your notes. Let's say you want to add a picture. Click Picture, select the photo you want, then click Insert. If you want to upload a web link, go to the top menu and click Insert, then Link. In the box, paste the link you want to include on your notes. As long as you're connected to the internet, you can click this and go straight to the web page. Tags help you prioritize notes. You can mark text as important or remind yourself to carry out an action. To do this, highlight the notes on your page and then go to the Tags section located at the right side of the home menu. To highlight or mark up notes, highlight the section and select the right tool from the Tags drop-down menu. Let's change these notes into a checklist by clicking on To Do. You can scan and upload documents directly from your phone on the OneNote app. Launch the OneNote app on your device and go to the page you want to add the document to. Hold your finger down on the screen and a menu will pop up. Click on the camera icon and then select Take Picture. Select the document option and then press Done. The picture will appear on your notes page. Go to the page you want to leave an audio note on. Press your finger on the screen and select the microphone icon from the menu. This will start the recording. Once you are finished, click Stop Recording. Your voice note will appear on the screen. You can operate OneNote using a stylus on your tablet. First, open OneNote on your iPad or tablet. You'll need to have the application installed. Make sure that your stylus is synced to your device. At the top menu, select Draw, and then you'll be able to draw directly onto the page with your stylus. If you want to switch back to the text mode, click on the icon at the top menu. Text mode is on the left side of your screen, while the draw mode is on the right. If you want to draw shapes, click on the Shapes tool from the top menu. If your drawing comes out wonky, OneNote will recognize it and correct it automatically. To arrange text, click on the Lasso Select tool and drag the text to the desired location of the page. You can use the immersive reading feature to have notes read back to you. On the top menu, select View, and then Immersive Reading. Everything on the screen will blank out except for the text. Then click on the Play icon. Activate the voice feature, and you'll hear your notes being read back to you. Remember to check that your volume is turned up. Click on the Share tool on the far right of the screen. This will allow you to share your notebook with others. From the drop-down menu, click Invite People to Notebook. Type in the contact of the person you want to share your notes with, and then click on the Share box. If you'd like them to be able to edit, click the Edit box here, then complete by clicking Share.